James gave me a call the other night and he said, you know, I've got great, exciting news. He said, I was looking down a couple rabbit holes and I found an article in the Tucson paper about a lost ruins that had been dug up when they were doing some excavating for a highway. And we couldn't find any more information. And one of the things about it, there was like 14 skeletons that were found that were actually taken back to another native area to be buried properly. But we never could find any other articles about where this thing was. And I'm going to leave a link up here so you can take a look at this article so you can see what we do when we try to decide what we're going to do when we go out. So we had this plan to try to encompass the Oak Flat area near Superior. And we're going to take a 5-mile loop on it. And it's really amazing when you look at it, you know, hindsight's 20/20, but you can kind of get into what we do. And what we found was one of the most incredible adventures that we have been in a long time. And what we thought was going to take us weeks, months, maybe a year to find, we ended up finding it in the same day. How crazy is that? Never expected that. So we're going to take you on this journey, and I hope you enjoy this as much as we did. But so at the first part of this video, we're going through the process of what we're going to do to try to find this. And at the very end, we'll show you one of the craziest stories that we've come across or dealt with forever. I hope you enjoy this. Take a look. Deduct it, and please like and subscribe, and hope you enjoy it. Jay Shrek.
And James.
You know, looking for some lost ruins today. You know, James did a little bit of a sleuth, and what we found out was, you know, if you want to think in this day and age there's not lost ruins in Arizona, you're probably mistaken, because a few years back, some were found. And this is just a few years back when they were doing some excavation or some surveying for a highway. Is that correct, James?
Yeah, that's what we read.
So what we found out was something, a place that we already knew had some type of special feel, and that people, natives, are still coming back here, and they have been for hundreds of years. And we're in an area that is definitely something I would say is intriguing, and there's possibility of there being ruins. Well, we know they're here. We just don't know where. So right now what we're doing is we're scouting the area out at Oak Flat. So a lot of people ask James, you know, well, is there anything new to find, or, you know, and you found this on the internet, right?
One story. That's right. What kind of intrigued me about this is I went and then I tried to find all the key searches that would, right, go along with this. Nothing. So.
Because, you know, we put out a video looking for lost ruins, and a lot of people thought we met the one that was down there where everybody found, right? But the reality it was, what we're looking for is, I don't know of anybody that knows this. I'm sure somebody does, right, that knows this ruin, because they were trying to keep it double secret, right? This is more kind of like a, you know, a cover-up, right? It's more, that's really what it is, right?
You could call it that, because clearly there was some stuff going on with the land and who owned it and who was responsible for the remains they found.
So they found 14 bodies.
Yep.
Okay, skeletons. Oh, I shouldn't say bodies, right?
Yeah, no, it was like old remains.
14 skeletons. So that's one of the reasons that all of a sudden they had to come clean. Now, supposedly, right, mm-hmm, there is a survey crew, and they're looking at expanding the highway that somehow is connected with the mine wanting to buy more land, right? Mm-hmm. And all of a sudden, they stumble on this village, right?
Yeah, the remains of a village of some sort.
And if they wouldn't have found the 14 bodies, we may not have known about this. And this is new stuff, though. This is relatively 3-4 years old. This is not like 100 years old or 20 years old.
Yeah, the article from a Tucson newspaper was dated 2014. So, and it had just been discovered in October prior to that.
Yeah,
release.
And this was, I think that was December. So December 14th, so right there at 15, right?
Yep.
And so to think that there's still stuff out there that you can find. Now, the funny thing about this is the coordinates that they gave basically was Oak Flat 5 miles, right?
5 miles west of Oak Flat Campground.
Well, that would either be on the other side of this mine right over here behind us. But they also said that the 60 highway was going to cover it up, right? So we're thinking that there's only one flat that's through here. And it was right in this area, which we already know is a holy place.
Was that interesting?
Man, that, I tell you what, this day has been so incredible. It's been absolutely fascinating to me is because two things that didn't get planned that just happened, right? All, just boom. And then all of a sudden we're in these areas that just, you can feel this out here. And, you know, we didn't expect to find that ravine where the climbers were and how cool that was. And you could definitely tell it was spiritual. And then you get here, and then all of a sudden this campground is, man, it's special, and you can feel it's special.
Yeah, we've driven by this a bunch of times, never really had time or, you know, a reason to stop. We just pulled off the side again, kind of like how we found the pond and Atlantis and the climbers and stuff, and then all of a sudden, like, bam, we're in this really beautiful campground area that actually turns out to be traditional Holy Lands for,
yeah, from the Wayback Machine. Yeah,
like, you know,
let's see what we got. I'm gonna take some shots myself. Every area right here, and I do not know what it means for the clothing, and I do not know what the That is pretty interesting. If you notice these little like spirits on this tree. So we have all the ceremonial crosses here, and this is where I'm told that they do the dances. And I was told to think about this as I would a church and show that church the same respect. You know, one thing we believe in is documenting. We think that respects it more than anywhere. I don't know what a lot of this stuff means, but I do respect the fact that, you know, that this is the area in which, you know, the ceremonies take place. So on our journey, we stopped on Oak Flats, right,
yep,
James?
Oak Flat Campground.
And what really funny is we kind of just stopped and we saw a sign that said that you should respect the holy ground. And we always do, but we didn't know what it was. And it was like, I wasn't sure, so we talked to some of the people that were just kind of hanging out, and they were picking acorns. And what we found out was this is a site where the ancients came, and it's also a site then where the Apache came. And so what they do is they still have their ceremonies here. We've looked over there, and they said consider that like a church, right?
Yes.
So they've got the poles up, and that's where they do ceremonial dances, and they also build these wiki-ups. And this is basically the way that they used to build these was like this. Mm-hmm. So they do a lot of ceremonial dances and things like that, mm-hmm, at this area. And this is considered to be a very sacred area. So it's just amazing how they build these and how they put them together.
And they said also a lot of times what they do is when a woman or a girl is moving into womanhood, they have a ceremony and they have it here. And it's really a beautiful place. One of the gentlemen we talked to was picking up acorns, and he said they make all kinds of stuff out of the acorns, stews and things like that. So if you look at the structure of how it's put together, and they just strip the bark, right? And then build it, and then put it together. That is an incredible structure, it really is. You wouldn't believe how strong it is. It's incredible. Why don't you come on inside, James? Now look at this structure. It really is very homey. What is this? Are these onions that are through here? We'll have to do a little research on this, but what an incredible structure. And how nice it is, and how, you know, what'd you say, 6-7 degrees it feels like cooler in here?
It's absolutely cooler in here. It's really actually, I was not expecting that. I kind of thought because this is sitting right in the sun, it was going to be very uncomfortable in here.
Now, we've talked to three of the people that we've met through the journey, and you know, they basically, when we talked about history, is the same thing that we're all going through, is that a little bit of their culture, they feel like they're losing through generation to generation. They believe that technology is kind of taken their culture to a certain degree, that the youth of today, just like every youth, is more involved in some type of video games and things like that. And that, you know, they were telling us that there's very rare for people to speak Apache, you know, that people understand. And that's going to be a lost art, a lost history. And, you know, and that's why it's important for us to be able to document this stuff, because, man, you don't know what's going to go away. Right.
Yeah, there's an Apache holy site just behind us here.
So we're now trying to see if we can't find this lost ruin that's in Superior, which is kind of incredible that there's still stuff to find. That's what's exciting to me, James, right? I mean, there's shit out there, right?
Absolutely.
So, I mean, that's why we're... The thing that's funny is I don't know if they dug it up. You know, they kind of said they did, but then again, I mean, why were they digging? I mean, there's so many things we don't know, but we're going to find out. We're going to, you know, because we don't believe it's 5 miles away, but next we'll go towards the mine. And I can't tell you we're going to find anything here today, but we do know that this place was heavily, Apaches used this ground regularly for 100 years.
Hundreds of years, and then it goes back way further than that. The supposed ruins we're looking for are actually Salado, which is
an offshoot of the Hubble Cone.
So this is, 1100, 1400 AD.
But the thing that amazed me, and we're going off two kind of things, is that so as we deduct and try to decide where to look, right, is that they said the 60 highway, the new widened 60 highway, and we just happen to be in an area right here at Oak Flats, which it needs to be widened, right?
That's true.
So it could be here, or it could be on down, and it actually could have been east instead of west. You know, and they might have been throwing you off because this land. So let's talk about conspiracy, and let's talk about dirty, and let's talk about the mine wanted the land, right? And so what they did was they levied a bill buried in another bill. Is that correct?
Yeah, National Defense Bill.